Thanks everyone for joining. And so I and Kathy Wu are going to be teaching this course in reinforcement learning. And this course is really, you know, suited for anyone who thinks that there's a problem that is exciting and they want to apply reinforcement learning, but they don't know how to apply reinforcement learning or which reinforcement learning algorithm to use. And, you know, instead of covering the very, very basics in this course, we end up, you know, covering some of the more advanced topics. So I have a few slides so that I can give you maybe a breather of what we have in mind. So there are, you know, many success stories of reinforcement learning, right? I mean, in many games, but also in, you know, real world control applications. Right. But the question that we would like to ask is, okay, these successes have come in reinforcement learning, but how do we get success on new problems? Right. And if I have a new problem, the question might be, should I use RL? Maybe should I use a variant which is hierarchical RL? Should I use goal conditioned RL? Should it be on policy or off policy? Should it be offline RL? You know, should I be learning models or maybe learning from demonstrations? You know, how can we ensure the exploration is safe? You know, what if the environment dynamics are non-stationary, right? As an example, you know, suppose you are Spotify and, you know, you are giving music recommendations and someone listens to this classical music, right? And Spotify really wants to engage customers, but they also want to explore so that they can discover new music interests, right? So Spotify would, you know, suggest new music. But what if Spotify suggested Lady Gaga, right? That as far away from classical music as possible, right? This may not go well with the customer. You might end up losing the customer because you were trying to figure out his interest, right? But this can also become very costly in some other applications, for example, a robot crashing down. So in many scenarios, just collecting online data is not always practical, right? And what we need to do is to just have a data set that we have from the past and learn from that. You know, which is, for example, an offline reinforcement learning problem. So, you know, in this course, you know, this is the kind, the flavor that we want to do, right? I mean, we have some real world problem, but it has some constraints. For example, safety is a constraint, right? Or I cannot collect a lot of new data. If, for example, if I'm, you know, doing vaccine trials, which are happening right now, you know, we do not want to conduct a lot of, you know, random trials, right? I mean, you want to we want to be optimal in what trials we are conducting so that we can still find the best treatment plan or, you know, the best vaccination plan and so on and so forth, right? Or similarly, you know, if I'm making a website and I want to say which version of the website should I show to my customer, right? Version 1, version 2, or version 3, right? Or, you know, another interesting application is in, you know, controls, where a recent, you know, work showed how to stabilize these balloons in the atmosphere, you know, just by using reinforcement learning, right? And there are many more applications in finance, trying to predict the stock market, you know, deal with, you know, some industrial workflows, human-robot interaction, or just doing robot manipulation. And the sense being, you know, there have been success in the academic world. How do we get to success in these new problems? So typically, if you look at these successes, they have come on standard benchmarks or on research problems, right? For example, these games and these control domains and so on. But in many of these games and domains, the problem framing has already been done by someone. You know, turns out this is a very important part of how to frame the problem if you were to solve a new problem. Right? Just as a simple example, now suppose I have this robotic agent, I want it to move right. Right now, I can say the reward is how much the agent moves right. So I can expect, okay, this agent is going to move on the right, but, you know, it can also fool and find a strategy which, you know, gets it more reward. For example, it can lie on the ground and kick itself, so it can still get high reward, but something that we really don't want, right? So, you know, how to design the reward function is actually quite tough. Right? And it is an iterative process where the human needs to come up with new rewards by observing what is happening. So if you were to look at some of the, you know, state of the art data sets which are there, the reward function is very, very hand engineered, right? For example, it's almost a program, right? If I want to have this agent go and reach the object, I'll write a program with all these funny numbers like 0.04 and so on, you know, more funny numbers, right? The point being, you know, there is a big disconnect between what is there in theory and how we practically apply it, right? Maybe it is coming in form of the reward function design, right? Maybe if you're dealing with the stock market, you know, the dynamics are non-stationary. The way the stock market behaves every day is different, but most algorithms are not set up that way, right? So how do we deal with these scenarios? Or how do we deal with multi-agent systems, right? So, you know, whereas the research and the study materials that you might find online maybe focus 90% on algorithms, 10% on hyperparameters, and 1 or 2% in problem framing, we think the right balance is the following, so that we can succeed on new problems. And that is what this course would be offering, with a focus on some of the more advanced topics like offline RL, you know, multi-agent RL, but also providing you in-depth knowledge of state-of-the-art algorithms like PPO, SAC, DDPG, and so on. And yeah, and one more comment I'll just make is, in terms of the problem domains, I don't think we are restricted to, you know, just robotics or control. I think between me and Kathy, you know, we have a broad expertise in different domains. For example, Kathy does urban planning, you know, she deals with multi-agent systems, but we would also consider, you know, examples from finance and, you know, optimizing workflows and so on and so forth.